Het vertaalproject is een project mede mogelijk gemaakt door de Nederlandse Taalunie en het Nederlandse Letterenfonds. And it's a project in which students from UCL, Sheffield and Nottingham work together in translating a short story by a Dutch or Belgian author. And that short story, together with the translation which we complete, is then published by the EU culture programme Citybooks.
Bobby, jij zit in groep 3, hè?
Ja.
Heb jij een vraag of een issue?
Ja. Ik wist niet als ik je dracht je strop 4 letterlijk moet vertalen. Er waren regels, maar je voelde ze niet. Die mentaliteit, zei je, heb ik hier in Gent teruggevonden.
Je draagt je strop 4. Dat was het eerste verhaal dat me naar Gent dreef.
Gentenaars zijn stroppendragers.
En wat betekent dat, Ed?
Ik weet eigenlijk niet iets met de geschiedenis te doen.
Maar jij weet dat wel?
Ik weet niet precies waarom ze stroppendragers zijn, maar dat komt uit hun tegenstand tegen de Romeinse keizer. Sommige mensen moesten door de straten lopen met stroppen om een nek.
Ja. Precies. Dus jij hebt het letterlijk vertaald, hè?
Nee, ik heb het in een idiomatische manier gedaan.
Dus wat wil je ervan maken?
To hold your head high, is what I've put.
You hold your head up high, you take the specificity out of it. And I wonder whether that is, do you think that's right?
Well, I didn't know whether we were trying to like encapsulate more understanding what is, like, what they're like, or the, like, cultural context behind it.
Mm-hmm. Well, what's more important?
Because it's for a city book, it's important to have the cultural context, because that's what they're all about. They're all about, like, promoting the culture.
Second page, like third paragraph, it's regel 75.
Lees hem even voor.
En ik wees hem op het werk van Gentse dichters die de wolken begrijpen en zien dat over de torens van de stad altijd luchtschepen voorbij drijven. It's not airships, because airships are clearly zeppelins. Like, you can't have a metaphorical airship.
Dat kan niet? Oké. Okay.
What did you do it as, Charlotte, in the end?
I ended up putting it as airships because Jonathan said that we read the Dutch and understand that it wasn't literal airships, it was ships sort of made out of air, in the air.
Because I think I went for ships of air.
Ships of air, I think you put,
But I think if I read it in English, I'd assume you weren't talking about actual airships, because you're already talking about clouds before, so I think you'd presume.
Als je te veel gaat beschrijven.
Ja, yeah, exactly.
Rewriting the text on
that. Ja, dan wordt het ook zo. Dan haal je de ziel er ook een beetje uit.
And a very special welcome to Jonathan Beaver, who's here. Don't you can all see. The only thing I need to arrange is we need a minute taker.
Can you hear me? Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, can you hear me?
Cool. Our group agreed on making that buigingen should be curtsying. And I agree. Yeah, okay, great.
Nailed it.
Great.
That was the best line of your moment. I thought it was great.
Oh, I'm so sorry, guys. Yeah, I disagreed.
No, I think it was
great that it was good then.
What you all did was to make two sentences out of it.
We've done kind of a melange of Dutch and English.
And then to do it in his style. And I was just wondering if that was intentional. Because it's really good.
Yeah, that's kind of something we all discussed.
What people have used for Gentenaar. Whether people have said locals or people from Ghent or whatever.
To keep the style and with the short, choppy sentences.
We said Gentenaars, we just kept it
in English. Gentenaar with an A or Gentenaar with an E.
Yeah, it was a kind of deliberate choice.
If you Google them, they're both really, you get most of the most hits from those two. And I have to congratulate
I thought it was fantastic to be part of City Books.
Echt interessant. I think it's been a really great experience.
Echt een heel leuk project.
Learned quite a lot.
I learned so much about translation.
It's really good to get some first-hand experience.
With the help of Jonathan, the professional translator.
We had to discuss cultural elements, linguistic elements that I'd have never thought of before.
You have to practice diplomacy and teamwork.
I found it very, very interesting.
That's really useful to do at university.
I've even thought about going into translation later as well, perhaps.